Hey, what's up everyone? It's the guy with the regular upload schedule again. Nah, just kidding, I'm fooling you. I'm not the guy. Anyways, what you're looking at is my modular battleship I'm currently working on. The idea is you have these slots, and if you're fighting a big ship, you have your capital gun in there, and if you're fighting aircraft, you can take out the gun and replace it with an anti-aircraft gun instead. As simple as that. But then I had one of my big ideas, and I thought, why should the battleship be modular? Why can't the guns themselves be modular? So a few hours of testing and one Reddit post later, I had a working solution for a gun that can change caliber and ammunition pretty much instantly. See, that's the problem with having a brain that's as big as mine, because when you have a really stupid idea, you can actually make it work. And so that pretty much ruined the whole idea of the modular battleship. Anyways, this is not the solution I originally came up with. It's a much simpler and better version I built after I had this video pretty much finished, so I had to do everything over again. It's a pretty normal gun, kinda ugly, but it works. And the special part is this blue part right here, which are the gauge increasers. And if I press a button, then these separators disconnect and the gauge increasers connect instead to those separators back here. So if I press J right here, you can see the gauge increases got moved back here, so they are not connected anymore. And suddenly the gun is 60 millimeters of caliber. And if I move them back to the front, now it's a 500 millimeter gun. And at the same time, I also switch ammunition, just trace rounds for show right here. But you can see the big gun is firing red shells, and then I remove the gauge increasers and suddenly we are spamming green shells out of the small gun, and then we reconnect them and we can fire red shells again. And the whole switching takes like 1 or 2 seconds for the gun to adapt. You can see it's takes a brief time, and then we can fire again right away. Brilliant, isn't it? You can have your capital ship gun, and then with a flick of a switch, you change it over, you have your anti-aircraft gun with its own ammunition, its own caliber, they're sharing the same components. Isn't that great? Now, the original idea I had, and that I also posted on Reddit, is a lot more complex for doing essentially the same thing, but I still think it's worth exploring further because there might be some potential in here, because it involves swapping components between different guns. Let me demonstrate the concept right here. You have pink gun, green gun, and gauge increases in red here, and once again the moving parts are in blue. And if I press a button right here, we swap over the components, move them over by one, and swap them back. So now the green gun has the gauge increasers, and if we move them back, then now the pink gun has the gauge increasers. These connectors, by the way, they're set to disconnect everything attached and in front, because with everything attached, it won't separate, because there's a connection between these blocks here, and that prevents the separator from separating. But with the setting attached and in front, it will basically look at this line, this mirror mode line that I projected here, and it will separate everything that's to the right of it, because that's in front of the separator block right here. There you go, that's how you separate it. And if you scale that system up, you end up with this connector ring right here, which has straight and diagonal connections which fit into the components from the gun right here. The colors are the same, by the way, as with this one here. I have the gun parts in red, main middle gun in green, and side guns in pink. And if we look at it in action, you can see right now we have 5 small guns. We press a button, you can see the ring down here spinning, and now we have one big gun. And the small guns, they are still here, but they're completely useless. You can see right here, no shell loaded. That's because they just have a few cooling components and they end right up here, because now everything you can see everything is connected to the main barrel. If I switch back, then you can see all of the guns are separated. And firing the weapons is pretty much the same thing. We can spam a lot of bullets with the flak mode, switch over to big gun mode, and we can shoot right away. And swap back and keep firing, no problem. Now this opens up a whole range of possibilities, because you can do this with probably any multi-block system. And I'm talking about like changing pack lenses based on distance, changing missile launch pads and thus the type of missiles, and so much more. Things I haven't touched on yet. But don't wait for me to do a video on that, because that's probably gonna take a few months, let's be honest with ourselves here. Just go out there and experiment for yourselves. If you want to start by analyzing what I've built here, I'll put this blueprint on a Steam Workshop, link will be in the description. While you're experimenting though, make sure you deactivate any separators that are lying around in prefabs or something like that, because you might manage to capsize your fortress. That happened to Helios, who was helping me brainstorm the whole thing. I'd say capsizing a fortress in From the Depths, that should be an achievement on its own. Anyways, that's it from me. Thank you guys so much for watching, and oh, and don't worry about the modular battleship. I've got some backup plans with what I could do with those slots.